Now, the history of the telecommunications started with the advent of the fixed telephony network. And this fixed telephony network is also called as the public switched telephone networks. And this is an example of the public switched telephone network. And here we have a fixed telephone. Now, the person that uses this fixed telephone, it is called as a subscriber. And we can see that this fixed telephone is connected to the local exchange using a pair of copper wires. And this local exchange is also called as the central office. And we can see that these two telephones are connected to this central exchange using the pair of copper wires. And the network of these exchanges is called as the public switch telephony network. Now, suppose that this telephone wants to establish a voice call with this telephone. So, to establish this voice call, first the fixed telephony network or the PSTN network would establish a dedicated path between these two telephones through the fixed telephony network. And this dedicated path is also called as the voice circuit or the voice channel. And using this channel, the bidirectional voice communication would take place between these two telephones. And since for this voice communication, first a dedicated circuit is established, so that is why we also call these networks as the circuit switched networks. Now, the evolution of the PSTN network started when Graham Bell invented the telephone in 1876, and it was a simple telephone like this. Soon afterwards, in 1878, the first telephone exchange was established in Connecticut, USA. And in these exchanges, there were human operators that used the manual switchboards in order to connect different telephones with one another in order to establish voice calls between those telephones. Then the crossbar switch was invented in 1915, and the crossbar switch was an electromagnetic switch, and in that time the telephones that were used, those were the rotary dial telephones. And in the case of rotary dial telephones, the user that wanted to dial some other user, he dialed the number of the called user using the rotary dial. And the pulses that were generated as a result of dialing the number, those pulses were then used by the crossbar switch in order to automatically connect the calling telephone to the called telephone. Then in 1960, the rotary dial was replaced by the tone pad dialing. And in this case, each digit represented a unique frequency. And depending upon the frequencies of the dialed digits, the telephone exchange connected the calling telephone to the called telephone. And then the electronic switches were introduced in 1968, which were called as the stored program controlled switches. Because in these switches, a computer software was used to connect the call of the calling telephone to the called telephone. And these switches were used for the analog exchanges as well as the digital exchanges. In the case of analog exchanges, the voice between the calling telephone and the called telephone was analog. While in the case of digital exchanges, this voice is digitized in the exchange. And the first digital exchange was established in London, UK in 1972.